I got involved with migrant workers before I started at Raincoats. So in 2014, very first instance that was kind of a turning point for me was when I found two workers on my street getting drenched in a thunderstorm. And I ended up taking them to my home in my car. I gave them shelter till the rain stopped and gave them some hot coffee, some food to eat, some of my husband's dry clothes to change into. And then when they left after the rain ended, I also gave them my number, said if you ever get into any trouble, you can always reach me, I'm a lawyer. A few months later, I got a call from the police saying one of those two guys had tried to commit suicide and the only number he had with him was mine. At that time, attempted suicide was a crime, so he was arrested. And because the only number the worker had was mine, he asked me if I was willing to go and post bail. So I did. But then I came back and I emailed the police to say that he was not really a criminal, he was a victim. Because when I met him, what he told me was he hadn't been paid his wages by his employer for 6 months. And he didn't know what else to do, so he just decided to end it all. And after a week, I got a call from the police officer in charge to say that they'd dropped all charges against him, they'd got his employer to pay him all his back wages, and he had been released. And then a month later, he was again at my gate, like a man reborn. He was freshly shaven and he came to thank me. So it was such a powerful revelation that with very little involvement, I could change the course for this man. So I started helping workers like that in my personal capacity. And then one of these posts went viral and then the Singapore Kindness Movement heard about it and they contacted me and they said, why don't you start something? And that's how It's Raining Raincoats was born.